Hello dear learners, welcome to today's program. I am Dr. Pallavi Gogoi of Krishnakanta Handik State Open University. Today, I shall be taking up Unit 7, the second video on Keki and Daruwala titled Wolf. And we shall discuss the explanation of the poem, Wolf. The course is General English, Semester 1, Block 1. So let us now quickly begin. First, I shall start with the learning objectives, followed by a brief introduction, then the explanation of the poem, and we shall move on to the questions to check your progress, followed by the references. Coming to learning objectives, after going through this unit, the learner will be able to explain the summary of the poem Wolf, grasp the core message embedded in the poem Wolf. To provide you a brief introduction, in this unit, we shall explore one of his selected poems titled Wolf, which contains a touch of the sadness and wonder in the imagination of a little child. The poem captures the image of a scared wolf out in the darkness of the night with searching eyes for a hiding place. The poem begins with a vague image of a form, a figure, or silhouette lurking in the dark, in the wilderness, as though it were hiding under the cover of darkness. This form is that of a wolf that haunted the imagination and thoughts of the poet as a child. Thus, the imagined presence of a wolf occupied the poet's mind as a child, as wolves were known to be hunted down at night by men. This imaginary wolf prowls the dark with careful and calculated movements out in the dark and, resting its snout on its paws, falls asleep on a bed of leaves. The presence of the wolf, whether it is in the dark outside, the poet's home, or in the poet's imagination, it happens to stir up an amazing sense of wonder and bewilderment in him. The poet describes the radiating presence of the wolf to a lit fire and to an unknown or unknowable myth. The mysterious form of a wolf in trouble captures the mind of the child in a very powerful way that it seeps, or rather nudges, into the consciousness of the child. You may well imagine how certain mysterious aspects create a deep impression and reside in the crater of the mind in little children for a very long time. In the same way, the poet remembers how, as a child, he had been haunted by the ringing cries of wolves at night. These cries were probably not the usual howling of wolves, but the painful ones when they were hunted down. It might have confused a child on how such a splendid form as a wolf, who had the freedom of prowling around its territory and hunting its own food, as you will find in the poem, words such as quote-unquote wind sniffer, throat catcher, was now a victim of the human world. So, the wolf was now suffering the fate of the hunted. Earlier, wolves were hunted not as much for game as for human security in the village. The poet's village home was at the edge of a forest, and perhaps for this reason the cries of the wolves were clearly audible to him as a child. In the days of his childhood, his mother would often narrate to him bedtime stories of wolves, describing how the sensitive ears of the wolves would pick up signals or any movements in its territory at midnight, out in the cold when dewdrops fell in the silence of the forest. You may perhaps know how animals are gifted with a sense of smell, whether for their food or for their sense of security. The poet remembers how his mother would tell him of wolves sniffing into his dreams and leaving in him a sense of emptiness in order to put him off to sleep. Those were the good old days of the poet's childhood. But now there were no more wolves left in those forests, as they were all killed by ruthless men. There were no more of those haunted presence of wolves or their tearing cries. All that was left was their absence alone. The dark bodies with lit up eyes were long gone with their radiating presence. Here I refer to the wolf or many wolves. All that remained were images of smoking gun barrels that stood for violence and bloodshed of innocent animals. The poet, as a father now to a little girl, only is left imagining how there were no more wolves to capture her imagination or dreams as there were in his time. So now we quickly come to the questions to check your progress. Question number 1. How does the poem Wolf by Keki and Daruwala begin? Question number 2. What does the imaginary wolf do in the dark? Question number 3. What did the poet's mother narrate to him in the days of his childhood? Question number 4. How does the memories of the poet's childhood differ from that of the present? Question number 5. What does the poet as a father to a little girl, realized towards the end of the poem Wolf. Here are the references. You could go through the self-learning material of General English, Block 1, Unit 7, Semester 1. Thank you, dear learners.